the day we go to the Palace of Versailles. The days are starting to get more difficult to wake up.
We're also sleeping later and later.
Oh damn, this is good. So it's gonna take like an hour going by train.
Oh my god, my feet! The callus is no joke.
Really? So if you wanna go to Versailles, depending on where you are, you catch the train to Montparnasse, which is actually a pretty confusing like train. It's like a
it's huge, bigger.
It's kind of like Penn Station. Yeah.
There's more than one kind of train that you can catch there.
So you switch from like their metro station to their like other bigger trains, and we could still use this, and we didn't have to use another one. So yeah. Oh, so we're going to a Michelin restaurant tomorrow. Lagape. It's like a Japanese French chef.
Being a little fancy.
There's actually really affordable Michelin star restaurants around the city, and because there's so many of them, you can get one for like a one star for under 50 euros, and it's like three meals. If you go at lunch, it's much cheaper than going at dinner. So if you want to save some euros, do that. I don't think I've eaten nearly as much baguettes and croissants as I would have hoped. Bread in general I've had an abundance of, because every time you go and eat at a restaurant or a cafe, they give you a bowl of bread. She never eats the bread. And then I end up just eating everything. No self-control for carbs.
The fact that I'm not eating the bread has nothing to do with her decision to eat all the bread.
No, but it kind of is.
You are still gonna do it regardless.
No, because if you
ate it, you're
gonna
ask for more bread.
No. Yeah, but if you ate the bread, then I wouldn't have to sit there looking at it and then just like naturally nibbling on it.
Like, you're doing it unconsciously, so you shouldn't blame it on other people because your actions are independent.
No. Are we there?
What?
We're just one stop away.
Whoa, what was that like?
Wait, but it should take an hour. No? Well, that was confusing.
That was a lot closer than I thought.
Oh, it's only 12 minutes.
And then what?
And then we just walked to the palace.
Really?
Yeah. It was only one stop away.
One stop away, but I thought that the stop would be further away.
Yeah, and it said on the phone it took an hour and 9 minutes to get here, and
so
we were here in like 12 minutes.
No,
okay, on the way. Louis the 14th. And of course there's hordes of people. Okay, so we are here. The line goes up there, down here, and back behind there. What the frick? Are we in the right line? Because we purchased tickets online to get out of this.
2,000 years later.
So we got in and we picked up some stragglers. And here we have the Palace of Versailles. It was one guy's like dream home, pretty much, and he had exquisite taste, and it took so much money to build the Palace of Versailles because he just, you know, wanted gold gates and all this stuff that you see, that it almost put, I think it did put France or Paris, it put Paris into bankruptcy, and so he was actually the last king or the last prince. And it's a little windy. Okay, so we're inside, so there's all these like portraits of, oh, this one looks kind of like a massacre. If you want, you can download an app from Rick Owens, and it actually has a podcast about Versailles or the different like things that you see along the way. Obviously it won't be in order of where you walk, but it just gives the palace more context. Voila. So we're gonna go out there later. It's just like 100 degrees. And let me show you the gardens of Versailles. I wonder how much maintenance costs. Okay, I have to get- acres are, but it's 300,000 acres.
Whatever that means.
Yeah.
This is like twice the size of Central Park.
And this is just one dude's garden.
But it's one powerful dude.
Okay, this one's a little unloved. Needs a little TLC. Alright, so coming up, this is one of the 400 statues. What's this person doing? Ah, just bathing in the sun. Okay, so have my map. Because like it wasn't confusing enough in the castle, it's quite confusing in the gardens. There are 400 statues in the gardens and 1,400 fountains. Crizzle. Ooh, I hear music.
Wait,
but I- Okay, now I understand how they let in so many people when we were lining up to get in. Because this place is massive. And another one. Another one. And another one. Another three. Two more here. And some more here. Okay, this is too hot. I give up. So this is a little epic. I don't know where this music is coming from. And this epic freaking river thing. And it looks like people are rowing boats over there actually.
This is quite amazing.
Taking notes on wedding venues. Totally kidding.
Woods.
Oh my god, imagine playing hide and seek here. That would be amazing. You would grow old and die before you find each other. This is the fields every morning. Been in the garden for a solid like hour.
No, being very productive.
And we haven't even gone very far, honestly. We walked down some steps and that's it.
Yeah. That's true. Oh,
but there's also these little narrow walkways and it reminds, what is it in Harry Potter?
Tri-Wizard Tournament.
Cause nice. Okay, music video time. And go. How deep is your
Oh, I really mean to learn.
Yeah.
Wrong.
Okay. Good.
How deep is your love? I really mean to learn.
Cause
in a world of fools, breaking us down.
Later.
Look at the lusty Asian taking photos. What if I just pushed her into the water? This is Sparta! Currently at Apollo's Fountain in the Grand Canal. This is at the very tip of the garden. So as you can see, each of these is like freaking massive. It's like, I don't know what you call it, but it's freaking massive. And we're here now. And still making our way through all the 50,000 gardens that are here. Selfie everywhere. This couldn't be more romantic. Okay, so we're in Marie Antoinette's house. And she's the wife
of Louis
16.
I guess this whole area is a gift to Marie Antoinette. She's originally Austrian and then she got married into this family.
Oh my god, look at this. Look at this. Wow. This is like every girl's dream room, like when you're little. Seriously, how many chairs are there in this room? How many friends did she have to need this many?
look at this terrace. And then you look on the left. Holy crap. This lady had her palette on point. Is this lavender?
Your dream house.
This is my dream house, man.
The next day.
Is it going? Oh, it's going. Okay. Day 5 of Paris. Look what Thomas Sang went to get.
Don't give out my whole name.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I'm kidding. You can give out whatever.
Back
just
to
not
the
my
bread.
Social security number.
Look at this bread, which has actually gotten pretty hard. Was it this hard when you bought it?
No, it wasn't. It was much softer before you went for a whole photo shoot. Are you still taking photos? Oh my god.
Wait, you need to put your phone back.
No.
Something's missing.
You're missing.
But look at this view. How can I not take like a million pictures of it?
I'm not bitter at all. Don't worry about it.
It's the most Parisian thing. And one of these squirrels.
Pistachio chocolate, rum raisin, and passion fruit chocolate.
Actually, French people have pretty light breakfasts. It's just like a croissant and coffee. Dude, last night was so loud and outside. Okay, so it was so loud because they were taking the scaffolding off this whole like building. I don't know what they were doing. That's the bakery, that's really good. Where is the little one?
Went for a breakfast with rum raisin, passion fruit chocolate, and the big ass bread.
Look at this mess.
This is your stuff.
What are we doing today? Guys, so finally out of the Airbnb after doing like freaking 5 hours of work. Anyway, so this is like our main destination today. Just thought we would take it easy because every day has been freaking full on. And the fatigue is starting to catch up with us, but we're at Sacre Coeur. So like just down there is how you get up here and it's like really touristy. And we're just slowly making our way up. It's really pretty. They have like lawns and stuff where people are just chilling. I haven't actually vlogged a lot today because I really screwed up the camera like that I usually vlog with, so now it's my phone. I don't know if you can tell the quality difference or the audio difference. There's probably a substantial difference. And yeah. Wow! To the top of the Sacre Coeur Tower.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Dude, and you're so tall as well.
Hi. Oh, I'm so hungry.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Completely lost. Ah. Dude, these are so narrow.
That's narrow as hell.
Round 2. Oh my god. And more. Oh my god. He's going. Yeah, it's like getting so narrow. But this would suck if you were claustrophobic, man.
Yeah, Tian is a little bit claustrophobic.
Oh no. Oh god. Okay, it's almost here. Let's
Wait, no, the avatar's
always. Oh my god.
Huh? It's over there.
Look at this.
Over there.
Look at this.
Hey, what is that area with all the skyscrapers?
This is awesome.
What's that tell you? Oh, hey,
look at the faces of triumphant people. Not so triumphant if I drop my phone.